really been stepping up his game here in the second half. He does miss the shot, but Forrest will not. Now it's a 3-on-1, and ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be NIP taking the first map away from Fnatic here in the grand final at ESL 1 Cologne. What an upset. This is the map that Fnatic picked.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. After that short break, we should be getting into it any moment now. But this already has been a terrific first map between NIP and Fnatic. They've already shown us just what they're capable of here. NIP with a perfect second half on their CT side. Fnatic never really finding a way to get back into that game. We have to see if they can recover here on Cash, which will be our second map, but a map both of these teams are extremely familiar with. They know all the ins and outs, Anders.
They definitely do. NIP ended up picking this map after Fnatic picked Cobblestone and lost on it. And the thing is, there is no guarantee that just because you pick the map, you're going to win it. So NIP, they can't feel too confident. That's what we ended up talking about before the break as well. But I am curious about how Fnatic are going to deal with everything here. They certainly have the players for it. They certainly have the minds for it as well. Question is if NIP have just a little bit more and they're going to be able to make it here for the third time.
Is that momentum going to carry over here onto that second map? I think that is the thing here. But Pronax is certainly the type of leader who will say, okay, I went, we thought we had an edge. I went for a bit of a gamble, took a map that I knew exactly, or at least I thought I knew exactly what NIP were going to be doing on. It didn't pan out, but we still have two opportunities to take this title. This is a best of three format here. So the next map will be Cash, and we should be getting into it just a moment's time. The pistol is about to begin, and Fnatic will be starting on the CT side here on the defense. NIP starting T side once again.
This is, if played correctly, supposed to be a counter-terrorist map. Not hugely, not like Nuke, where you can expect to win 12 or 13 rounds or something like that. But still, you should win the majority and preferably about 9. So that's what we're looking for here. Mid-control is absolutely important on Cash right now. And Fnatic here are going for a bit of a gamble as they do put 4 people inside that A bomb site, just waiting. And it's a single person over at B right now, so the gamble is pretty huge here for Fnatic. Once again, just like with map picks, they're gonna go for it, and now Olofmeister goes down, and is that the opening for NIP? Instant headshot, JW pushes in, Crims goes down, Fiflaren with the shot, JW one bullet left, he doesn't connect, and he's gonna go down. NIP now rushing into the bomb site, and Pronax in the back here. He's going to be Molotov out of position. He's in the middle of everything. No cover. He drops Fiflaren, picks up the double kill, and now Flusher 1-on-4 here. Bomb plant delayed for a second, but what can he possibly do?
This is so tough for him now. He's going to eat nade damage as well. Drop down to 30 HP. He's been spotted. They know exactly where he is. Forrest already putting shots through that smoke. He walks right into Freiburg, and the headshot is there. Get Right raises his hands, but you have to admire how it works out in that pistol round right there. Fnatic going for an aggressive play, and as we said, they needed to destabilize NIP early. They needed to shake their confidence, and that was exactly what that strap was designed to do. Get up in their face early on at A main. Get those kills early on, but NIP, they had two guys camping right outside the squeak door. They heard Fnatic coming, and that allowed them to rotate in and completely counter them.
Fnatic going for a huge left hook, a knockout blow to NIP, and they lean right into a right there. That's going to be taking them really down a couple of notches here. They do pick up a scout and also, of course, CSET 75s and body head armor.
Interestingly enough, it's Crims who's going to be using this scout. Now, we've seen Crims use scope rifles in the past throughout these playoffs matches, and he has had excellent results as well. So him having the scout, not that big of a surprise, actually. We'll see if he's going to be able to actually put it to use here, seeing how it's such a powerful gun. But Olofmeister, in the meantime, manages to get the drop on Freiburg, and that's the CZ-75 going to work once again.
And NIP generally haven't been very good at managing the anti-eco rounds, like a lot of teams in this tournament haven't. So this early loss here is maybe going to affect them. They steal the Galil as well here. Olofmeister now with Galil, armor, and grenade. Not at all bad to start off with here in the second round. There's a body shot coming in as well. Crims, can he get another one here? Looking for the angle, and he's got cover and Flusher here. CSET 75 in hand. The timing is going to be everything. Flusher waiting patiently, and the patient pays off. He's going to pick up the one and launch out of bullets, but it might be enough anyway. Crims inside has already picked up a couple of body shots, and he needs just one more here. Jumps to find Get Right. There's JW. W, and Get Right's alone. A great second round from Fnatic already.
Get Right about to get caught as well. The flank is real. He's going to have a man closing in behind him. That's Olafmeister already using that Galil that he picked up earlier. And Get Right gets the headshot first. Unreal. But there's only 8 seconds left on this clock. Get Right cannot get anything done past this point. Decides to run and save his gear. And that is definitely the right decision to make in this situation. 1v3. Now, you have to admire Crimson, his self-control there going into that round. Because he gets the information. He spots the man out, tags him. But then instead of actually going for a re-peek, instead of giving Nip a chance to find the shot on him, he backs off to that site, feeds the information to his teammates, and sets it up for Flusha to get the perfect flank on Nip. So Fnatic definitely keeping their cool here. They deserved to get that second round after plays like that.
Very, very nicely done. This is a map that shares something in common with a map like Nuke, where in the anti-eco, it's really hard for you not to get close to the pistols that the CTs have picked up. You have to get within pistol range, so maybe NIP need to come up with a different answer once they get into that position. If they do get into that position again, grenades are going to rain in here, and it's Pronex holding, and he's actually very much alone. These grenades are so good for NIP. Pronex goes down, the backup's going to have some trouble. They charge right through the smoke. They're not going to be waiting. Now Fnatic have a great presence on this bombsite, but Freiburg, instant double headshot, Get Right with a kill on Pronex, and the bombsite is lost.
The bombsite is gone. Great nade there from Crims. He still has that scout in hand. If he can tag, both two members here for NIP are fairly low. But they have to play it safe, and he's waiting for his teammate Flusha to rotate in from short. This is going to be the split play here from Fnatic, trying to get an edge on Nip, but the backstab is already under effect. Get Right is right behind them, and there is no way out now for Fnatic. They are boxed in, and the last thing they're going to expect is the backstab from Get Right. Works perfectly. Crims will rotate around and manage to pick up a gun, and this could be pretty big here. If he gets another kill, that would be great, but it's not going to happen, and he gets boxed in in CT spawn. So, Nip strike right back in the third round, come out swinging, and take it away from Fnatic.
And the question is, and this is what I was wondering, are they going to go for this really dangerous pattern where they try and force it up again? So they will actually do that, and that's something that could really have a big effect. We've seen this earlier in the tournament at least two or three times already, where a team just decides to keep forcing for a long time, and if it eventually pays off, if Fnatic get a round off of this, then it's all worth it. If they don't, they could end up double ecoing.
Exactly, but if they're in that kind of situation right now where they want to even out their money, if three of them have to double eco anyway, definitely a strong play here from Fnatic. And we've seen how lethal these pistols can be. 5-7 on Pronex, but he really is an exception to the rule. Olafmeister and Flush are going for the CZs, and two rifles picked up. Now we have to see if Fnatic this time can land the shots, because Nip, they're here to party, they're here to play, and they're about to take over. Palm site A, there's Olafmeister gets one, but it's only the one. Still getting the information, feeding it back to his teammates. Pronex still alive with the 5-7, picks off Bitfloren, and he could get a second, but will shut him down.
Fnatic really staying alive for a long time here, allowing more time for JW to get in, so it's a really good job from Olafmeister and Pronex then. Flusha is walking up from behind as well. This could be really great. JW does go down. They're already shooting at that wall here. He's going to take the peek, and Exist is ready for it, but Get Right and Exist are very low on health. Fnatic could definitely take this round, and that would be such a great performance if they could. Krim is missing a shot with the scout, missing once more. That's two really vital miss now. Flusha is not going to miss. He takes down Get Right. Bomb will be planted here, but Exist, this is a really terrible one-on-two for him. A single bullet, and he's going to be gone.
But a single bullet from him will take out either of these members as well. If he can land the shot, we have to see. He knows that there's a man in A main, and that is going to be the flank coming in here from Flusha. Krims is waiting on short with that scout as well. Exist boxed in very thoroughly here by Fnatic, and he tries to turn around. He tries to bait out a reaction from Flusha, but Flusha is just too quick, and now the defuse is coming in. 5 seconds left, and they will have ample time. Fnatic, I mean, this is so back and forth, Anders. This has turned into a real brawl here at the beginning of the half. The momentum is crucial for both of these teams, and neither one of them is going to turn away in this game of chicken.
And NIP have enough to actually buy 3-on-3 players. I'd be shocked if they don't, and they will indeed pick it up. In fact, Exist has so much money, he's going to buy a Galil and drop it to a friend. So now they have 4 rifles on this team, and that's the bomb plant that made they could do that. If Exist hadn't got the bomb down that previous round, there would have been a full-on eco for NIP. So we're in the 5th round here of the first half of the second map here, ESL 1 Cologne, and now it gets interesting again. Fnatic gotta win this. Forest looking for a kill in the middle. Look how aggressive and confident he is, charging in with the AK-47 in hand. And he's got a lot of information already. Pronax, though, will pick up the opening kill on Freiburg.
It's going to slow Nip down somewhat here, but Forrest is in a position to be able to catch a man off guard if they get too greedy. Krims goes for the spray down, but Fifloren gets the best of him. And now Flusha has to chuck in the incendiary to slow things down. He can't let Nip speed up behind this. Forrest, unfortunately, does not find the kill on Wolfmeister, and the line holds for Fnatic. They maintain the man advantage. And Nip, they still have nades to work with here, though. So they can still make something happen for themselves if Fnatic give them the opportunity, but I really do love this play from Fnatic. Olafmeister could just completely rock them, but no Exist is waiting on the other side. Not fooled, and he could get the second frag, but JW's too quick.
He definitely should have got that second frag. That was a big mistake from Exist. He could have just walked casually and then got that one. So maybe a little bit of nerve coming into play then, but that was almost 100% kill there. If you flare in and get right now, 2-on-3, and Flusha waiting inside this bomb site, 30 seconds left, and this is going to be really tough, especially because Fnatic's actually already making a rotation, so NIP have got to move very quickly here, and Flusha smartly waiting, not peeking, just really good play. He's going to pick up the headshot here on Fuflaren, and now it's a 1-on-3 for Get Right. Flusha will take him down. Solid play from this counter-terror side.
Yeah, very patient play, and there's the tap from Devil Walk on the shoulder, making sure that these guys are definitely...
I actually think that if Exist picked up that kill in the middle, that would have been NIP winning the round right then and there.
Absolutely, that was a crucial frag from JW in managing to crouch and spray and actually find the kill on Exist. And I think you are right. I think Exist did rush it a little bit there. Had he walked up, it would have been perfect. But Exist, of course, doesn't want to let the man that just boosted someone get away either. If JW was running, he could have got around into sandbags, and then it gets a bit tricky there. That's the way that it happens, or that it plays out this time, though. Nip are on pistol now, however, and they actually just have to deal some damage to Fnatic. They cannot let Fnatic's economy get out of control. And Fnatic certainly don't have much in the bank right now, so it's crucial for Fnatic to just have a perfect hold. But I actually like that Freiburg is going for a bit of a swag over there at Squeak Door. Open, close, draw the attention there.
Yeah, Swag's variation of that play, actually, which is interesting, is to play with the door a little bit and then start shooting through it, hoping someone's going to peek. So something that Freiburg didn't do in that situation, but you're right, Swag from iBuyPower is, I think, one of the best players in the world at playing that Squeak Door.
Absolutely.
On cash. So if you ever want to learn a little bit, he's a really good guy to watch for it.
We've seen him single-handedly wreck teams from that position. Teams having to put three guys on A just to deal with him than the pressure that he's putting out. But now it begins. Nip going for the double boost into mid. JW calmly clicking them away, however, with the help of Krims, but JW yet another one. This is just a series of frags. JW wants to pad his stats. He's got 4, and Freiburg already wrapping around, looking to get the flank, but Flusha, he's got his mates back. No way in for Nip in that round, and they actually don't accomplish much at all apart from, well, padding Fnatic's coffers. And that is definitely not part of the plan here for Nip. Fnatic, it seems like they won the game of chicken, Anders. They've stabilized here.
They have, and that's very, very important. That looked like it was going to be a knockout blow to them when they lost that first pistol round, but they kept their heads in the game, and somehow they got back in it, so that's really impressive. Shows a lot about the strength of character that's on this team. We're moving into the 7th round, and I like to see NIP try and go for something that's a little bit more aggressive, maybe. What I would love to see them do is a big crunch on the B bomb site, where they actually go for this event where Flusher is, smoke off the middle so the people in the middle can't help out, and then try and just rush into checkout and B bomb site quick. I think that something really snappy here could work out great for the Swedish Ninjas.
And they're actually doubling up over here as well. Fnatic really putting a lot of focus on mid, but this really has been the focal point so far in this match. Bit of the wall bang there from Pronax trying to tag up Freiburg. Freiburg looking for him as well, but nothing has been done apart from giving away the information as to where people are on this map for now. There's still a minute left on this clock, however, so Nip, plenty of time. I mean, we can see just how spread out they are right now, really trying to cover all of the angles, because Fnatic can push. Fnatic can try and get out there and get that info. And Nip, they would be more than happy to get the advantage by getting that frag and the punish.
Flusha actually getting Molotov back, and they were waiting for him as he dropped out of the vent. So a tiny trick there from NIP. If they had wielded a kill off of that, that would have been perfect. But as it is, they've just wasted a lot of time, and now 30 seconds left, and Fnatic still holding their ground. So got to give some credit here to the CT side, making sure that they don't really do anything at all. And they've got a pretty heavy presence here at the B bomb site. NIP are going to go for it with just 20 seconds left. This is going to be flawless. It's going to happen. But JW already taken down one. They're pushing up through Flaren and Get Right, getting some good kills in, and the bomb is going to go down. And look at NIP's full post-plant positions here. They're so good. Moving out of the bomb site, leaving one guy in. It's exactly what you want to play this like. Fnatic now have to look all over the place to get the kills before they can actually defuse this bomb. Pronex is waiting right here, and he's going to be flashing in once. Can he get Exist down? He's playing a mind game here. Geroy goes down by the playground. Pronex looking for it, but he goes down. Exist with a great headshot through the wall. Then Olofmeister comes in to take care of him, but now this bomb is already far ticked. They have the kid on Olofmeister, but if you flare it, is holding, but he's not going to be holding long enough. And they can get the defuse. So a really good retake here. It's very close, but Fnatic, they will be able to win the round.
And that was actually a mistake there by Fiflaren, really managing to turn that into a 3-on-3 situation. We can see, I mean, the happiness on Olofmeister's face after that play. Pronax as well. They are definitely getting confident here in this CT half for them. But at the end of the play, Nip, they had the 3-on-3, they had the afterplant positions, and honestly, if Fiflaren waits one more second there before peeking out. Yeah. One more second before peeking out, they have that round. Fnatic don't have the time for the defuse. So
that may be true, but the problem is he doesn't know if someone's flanking him from his left hand side. So if he stays behind the box, they're going to become running up. The big issue, the thing that really screwed that round was actually Geroy going down by the playground. He should have been able to do more from that position, I think.
Crims. I mean, right now, Fnatic have really just got all of the momentum going their way. I think that's the most important thing here. And when a team of this caliber starts to really feel confident in their shots and their abilities, their calls, it's when NiP really start to struggle. So this is going to be all about now the picks, because NiP, they get the plant, so they're able to actually go for a pretty reasonable buy, but limited nades to work with. No HEs, only one flash. At least they have the smokes. So we have to see if they can find anybody peeking, but you have to actually admire Fnatic's patience in these rounds on their CT side. They're giving so little room for NiP to work in as far as actually picking up entry frags that would allow NiP to speed up behind it. And this is exactly the style designed to counter NiP, because NiP are a team that thrive off of entries. Once they get that first frag, they're incredibly good at speeding up behind it and overtaking a site. Fnatic playing so passively, so patiently, means that NiP have to come to them and things like this happen. JW forces out the error and manages to catch Forrest with that AWP.
Yeah, Crims are going to pick up a good kill here on Fiflaren, and this is not working out at all for the Terrorist side. Just getting picked off one at a time. Really good defense from Fnatic. And now we're talking about 5 rounds in a row on the CT side of Cash here. Now, NIP picked this map, and I'm wondering, where are some of those cool Terrorist side strats that we do see on this map? There are a lot of different stuff you can do here. Boost in the middle we've already seen, but like I was talking about earlier, there are some really cool rushes you can do to the B-bomb site too that could work out. And even just trying to take more mid-control, NIP have been very passive in the middle, apart from those boosts.
Well, they have 4 flashes and 2 smokes right now, and they're heading over towards A. Are they going to go for a bit of a mixed boost? It seems like the first 3 are going to be going into A main, 2 into Squeak, and NiP, they definitely want to get out here fairly quickly. I like how they wait already to see if they can get a punish on anybody pushing in here by Fnatic early on, but now NiP gather, and this is going to be the tank of tanks. Can NiP land the shots? The Molly's going to go down from Olofmeister. That's going to get pretty hot in there fairly soon here for NiP, but they have to go charging through. They're actually running out of time here. The rotation will be coming in from Fnatic. The crucial kills have to come through, and so far, Fnatic are lighting them up. NiP, only 1 kill going their way.
Yeah, oh, and a second one from Fnatic. These pistols are doing something good here for NIP. They've already got 2 kills. Picking up one more would be great, but it's not going to work out. JW makes sure it stays at just the 2. Still fairly successful eco round, I would say, for NIP, investing in a couple of grenades and coming away with 2 kills. The bomb plant would have been great, and I think those smokes were meant to try and secure a bomb plant. Doesn't work out so well. 10 rounds in, and now is a unit double up set up for Fnatic here. JW and Olofmeister both. Now I'd love to see NIP make a change, and I think they will. These 3 Molotovs they have tells me it could very well be an A push coming out here.
I mean, they can cover quite a bit of ground with that. We usually use it to check the corner around Squeak, behind quad boxes, at the back corner of the site. Molotovs are very useful for taking over that A site, but they can be useful for basically starting the burning ring of fire on B side as well and forcing the defenders off of that bomb site and really opening it up. Freiburg has the Molly in hand there, but they aren't really going to be doing too much with it. What I really like from Fnatic here is that this double op play just shuts down practically half of the map. JW and Olofmeister both terrors with these rifles.
Look at this. This Molotov is going to fake the vent. So this is going to pretend, they're pretending right now that it's a B push. Try to force back Crims. He will force back. And that's what they did last time. They did a B. Unfortunately for them, Flusher picks up the kill in the middle on Forest. So now maybe Fnatic are going to realize. In fact, they will realize they're already rotating up. And it's a 4-on-5 right here. Olofmeister in the back by the quad boxes. A lot of fire. but no real action from NIP, and Fnatic are in such good positions. I don't see this working out at all. Flusher, easy kill on Freiberg, goes for the kill and squeak as well, but if you flounder exist, they do return a little bit here. Olaf Meister sees set 75 to the face, and it's a quick double for Olaf. Very, very cool play. Now get right in a one-on-two with 30 seconds. He's gonna go for the plant if he can. Be hugely important if he can put this bomb down. He's got 25 seconds. Can he make it a one-on-one? Not quite. JW, that was so close by Get Right.
That was so close. That was a pixel off right there. JW strikes faster, however, and that is going to be yet another round going towards Fnatic. 8 rounds now on the board for them. 2 only here for NIP, and this is really when NIP start to feel the pressure. I think they need at least 5 rounds on this half to feel confident with their performance in this first half on their T side. And they, I mean, with how difficult it is for them to be able to get onto these sites, and for them to deal with how Fnatic are playing this right now, those 3 rounds, that's a lot to ask, I feel. So NIP, again, going to be able to go for a buy. Get Right, in fact, going for that AWP on the Ninja's side. And we saw how effective that was. He had a couple very strong rounds on Cobble. We have to see if he can pull it off here on Cash. JW already waiting around the angle, and this could be brutal.
It will be brutal. It's a headshot, no less, onto Get Right. I do actually still love the idea, but you're challenging Get Right, or so JW and all of mine, so it's going to be difficult. That's a great long distance headshot there from Forrest. Then a second one picked up. Now it's time for Forrest. He's angry, tired of losing rounds. They've lost 5 in a row, or even more than that, actually. 7 in a row is what they're up to now, so they want to see if they can bring it back.
Forrest trying to make it happen here. They've got the man advantage now. He needs to play it patiently. He still has 2 nades on him that can help take a site, but he's off on a mission. He's trying to sow confusion in the ranks. Fnatic already with the setup, however. Olafmeister putting that AWP to use. He's been smoked off from CT now, however, so he has to actually try and work his way through. JW looking from on high. It's a double op hold, and Fnatic need to land the shots. It's absolutely crucial.
Look at who's coming up from behind. If they get this bomb down, there's a backstab. In effect, Olafmeister goes down. It's a 2-on-3. He misses the shot. They are being crunched in. Fnatic gotta commit right now and get the kills. JW trapped, but he's gonna go down. Forrest with the triple kill. Perfect movement from Forrest. The first 2 headshots were great, but the decision to trust in his teammates to get into that bombsite and then backstab Fnatic, that was very, very cool.
And these are the kinds of plays that NIP are capable of because of that trust, because of the ability of everybody on this team to step up when it's necessary and land the key frags. NIP sneaking below heaven as well, predicting where JW would be watching from, and then managing to get on that site to get the plant. Very well played there by the Ninjas. Fnatic, despite their best efforts, couldn't hold them back. But now we have to see Fnatic bounce back. They have plenty of money to re-equip with ops, and Olafmeister already picking off Ifloran and gets the second frag. Get Right is out of it, and Fnatic right back into the mix. 2 kills and a huge advantage going into this round.
3-on-5, trying to challenge Olafmeister again, turning out to be a really bad idea for NIP. And actually Fnatic, well, I mean, NIP don't really have enough money to buy an extra round. They might force it up anyway, just try and see if they could get up to 5. But if NIP could end up winning this round, Fnatic would have 2 players that wouldn't be able to buy. So there's really a lot riding on this one round for both teams. But it looks like Fnatic are stabilizing. And again, they're making great decisions on where to actually hold. They seem to really read what NIP are doing quite well.
Now, this is the difference between one of the newer maps and one of the older maps that these teams have so much experience on. Both of them, in fact. And now we can see that effect having here. Olafmeister missing his 3rd shot. However, he's still alive and on this site. And so long as that remains the case, it's going to be tough. But the flank comes in from Grimms. He's going to get 2 kills. And we're into a 3-on-1. Forrest stuck in checkered, nowhere out. No way to get out of that room. Flush up with the flank will obliterate NIP. And now we look at a very tough decision here for NIP. Do they decide to eco and bank it all on the 14th round? Or do they decide to force up here? It would be amazing if they did that.
Yeah.
They have to go for pistols and nades here and really just put it all in that 14th round.
Yeah, forcing it would mean 1 rifle essentially and then CZs on everyone else. And that's a little bit more than they're willing to invest into, especially because if they did that, we could be seeing a 12-3 first half here for Fnatic. So NIP gambling on 10-5 instead of anything else.
NIP once again is really spreading out across this map as well, trying to see if Fnatic are going to get greedy. We haven't really seen that from Fnatic, however. JW is actually taking a little bit more of a peek than usual. Really looking to see if he can't get ahead of NIP, but it's going to be Crims with an insane flick shot. What a headshot on Forrest. Very nice reactions there displayed by Crims, and we've been seeing terrific play from him throughout the entire tournament. Him and Olafmeister both are big parts of why Fnatic are this far in the tournament now.
JW seems to be almost unstoppable in this position. I wish they would actually figure out a way to deal with this. They can grenade this spot, and Freiburg's gonna use a pistol instead to get rid of him. So that's a really important kill, just trying to stop JW. Pronax called with the grenade out, could have easily gone down then. That was very, very close. And is he gonna check the corner? Freiburg is right there by the forklift. Pronax, very quick, swift reaction here. And now get right, it's just a matter of time. Grenade rains in, and it's actually going to be Flusher with the rifle to pick him off. So nicely done. Eco round from NIP, so they didn't really accomplish much more than the one kill here. But I wish they could figure out a way to deal with JW in that corner, because that seems to be a place he's just holding for a number of rounds. And once it becomes too predictable, NIP should react to it.
I think NIP really, like, it's past time that they really try and change up their style here, because they're still looking for the pick play, but Fnatic are doing such a good job of playing passively, holding so far back that NIP really can't find the kills. It's really slowing up NIP and forcing them to go for these plays with 30 seconds left on the clock, and that's not enough time. I would love to see a very quick play out of NIP. Try and change up the pace. Go for an A rush, go for a B rush. Get in Fnatic's face early on here in these halves. Krim's already setting up to catch the man setting up for a play. Get right. Takes a bullet, but is actually going to be able to live.
A little bit of damage exchanged, but nothing more comes of it. And NIP, they're very determined to go to this B bomb side. And Fnatic, they're very determined to have three people here. It's a really good opening for Get Right. Picks up the one kill here. All of Meister covering. He's been so deadly with this AWP. And he's going to miss the next shot here. Got to be careful he doesn't get smoked off. And there is, in fact, a smoke for NIP. Now it's on Flusher to try and keep a count on how many people are down here. They throw some grenades up, trying to see if they can make the safe cross. But it's not safe when Flusher's watching. Takes down Fiflaren. And more grenades to follow. Flusher eventually goes down to Freiburg. And now it's a 3-on-4. Bomb is being planted here, but now NIP are almost all stuck inside the bomb site with the exception of Forrest. See if he can actually make the difference. I definitely think he can. Last time he did, except for a different angle. That's also going to be confusing for Fnatic. They do have plenty of kits and even a smoke here to try and prevent one access route back in from Forrest. Flashbangs rain in, but now it is a go. They're going to go for the retake here, and it's a 2-on-1. JW landing a shot through the smoke, not going to get it. He's going to go down to Forrest again. It is Patrick to come up from behind to save NIP.
Yeah, getting that entry again, crucial there for NIP, and we can see what happens. That's the thing. They find that frag, and then they instantly start applying pressure to the site, speeding things up, forcing the rotation out of Fnatic, but also just knowing how to deal with it. Ulfmeister missing that shot initially, and NIP taking advantage to smoke him off and get things rolling. So, once again, NIP, in a round that they cannot afford to lose, they need that fifth round desperately going into this second half. It is a bit CT side, and we see that Fnatic definitely demonstrating that with a strong defense, it's very tough for the T side to get in here. But for now at least, NIP once again just sneaking around. Not exactly spread out so far, and now I really love to see it. Are they actually going to manage to get in here quickly and find that opening frag?
And they try and flash, JW almost works, but he's still in the back here, jumping back to take a safer position. Pronax by the forklift, goes down, exists with the opening. JW now, this AWP is not good at this range, but he still picks up a grenade, another kill, a quick triple. JW crushing NIP in this bombsite, just long enough for the backup to come in. Now Get Right is in a 1-on-4. That is such a huge save from JW, and he gets the final one. The 4-kill comes up, Fnatic 11-4. What a beautiful first half for them.
JW been styling there at the end with the HE kill at the same time as the AWP kill. Two birds, well, with two stones, but hey, it works. JW really locking down that site, and that's what made it possible there for Fnatic, with Exist getting the entry onto it by a forklift as well. Really thought that that was going to go NIP's way. It was absolutely crucial that JW hold that position on the map and allow for Flusher to rotate in to support him. But right now, we're going to have both of these teams essentially talking it over, trying to figure out exactly what they have planned for us here. And I think a lot of that is going to be happening on Fnatic's side right now, because if they can pick up this pistol round on the T side, the amount of pressure that's going to be on NIP going into this beginning of the second half is going to be monstrous. Fnatic could just run away with the game right here and take this to the third map, which is Inferno.
Yeah, like we started off saying, this is a CT-sided map, but not like Nuke or anything else. So getting 11 rounds is very, very impressive. And I'd say winning the pistol round basically does give the map to Fnatic, unless NIP just go completely nuts. But I think even for NIP, this comeback would be too much to handle. At that point, you'd be at a 14-4 scoreline, and you should be able to win it, even being on the CT, on the terrorist side here. And we'll have to find out, of course. We are just waiting about 40 seconds left. If you're just joining us, then a big welcome here to the stream. This is ESL 1 Cologne 2014 at Gamescom, the third major tournament in the Counter-Strike Global Offensive Series. The first one went to Fnatic, and they're back in the grand finals. The second one here, that went to Virtus Pro in Katowice. That was also an ESL event. And now we have the third one coming up here with a rematch of the DreamHack Winter Major.
It's
really,
amazing.
Really impressive. impressive stuff coming up, and I hope you guys are enjoying it. Hashtag ESL1 on Twitter if you want to chime in and invite your friends. Now is the perfect time to get friends involved in Counter-Strike.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we're big shout out to the League community for tuning in, as well as all the others. This is the match to watch. It's two Titans clashing here in the Grand Finals. A rematch, as you said, from DreamHack Winter, but Fnatic and NiP, they go way back, and this is huge. Now getting into the second half here, it is going to be a change of sides. Fnatic now on the offense, NiP on the defense, and now the question is, can NiP secure this pistol round and give themselves a fighting chance in this second half, or do Fnatic just railroad them and take it to map three? We find out now, and what exactly do Fnatic have in store for us here? That's the question. Pronax, the mastermind, keeping quiet during the beginning, or during that break, not talking too much. So it really does seem like Fnatic, they've thought this out, they know what to do.
Yeah, they already have the solution. It worked in the first half, it's going to work in the second half. Great smokes coming up in the middle, and they're going to charge in. And this is what I wanted NiP to do. That's what I was talking about, quick rush into the vents, but they are going to actually fake it out here. JW is just pretending while the rest of Fnatic are seriously committed to taking this A-bomb site, and there's only the two people holding here. They're going to be charging in. Olaf Meister goes instantly down, exists with a blinding headshot. He's going to get killed by Crims anyway. Forrest picks up one and then goes down. A lot of trading, and Get Right is going to try and see if he can put an end to it. A bomb plant already. The first thing accomplished here from Fnatic, and now Crims and Pronax trying to hold it. NiP do have a kit, and they even have a grenade here.
Now the question is, where do they place this grenade? The HE goes raining in, and Pronax and Crims still alive and intact, one of them blind, and now NiP take advantage of that to start pushing in, applying the pressure. Pronax in a key position. The crossfire could be brutal. Crims alive still, and this is forcing NiP out into the open. Crims with two headshots, and this is the third. Pronax will tomb them, and Fnatic take the second pistol. This is now a brutal turnaround. NiP, this is their map to boot, and nothing is going their way.
It really feels like it isn't at this point. 17 rounds, and it's a 12-4 scoreline. This could very quickly turn into an Inferno map for the third in the Grand Finals. That would be pretty much an ideal situation for everyone watching.
Oh, that would be a thing of beauty. We have to go the distance. It has to be settled on the third map, 16-14. That's what we all want. We want it to go all the way. But Fnatic now, going for the boost up into mid. Nobody here though for NiP. This is just NiP going for a stack about as clean as you can get. 3-2, really counting on the CZs to work the angles and hold these sites.
Fnatic getting so excited that they actually forgot the bomb inside the T-spawn. They're so excited to win this game and move on that they don't even want to put the bomb down. They just want to kill NiP members and see if they can pull a little way home. And that's not a bad strategy, I say. That seems like that's the reasonable plan right about now for Fnatic.
And Fnatic actually with a healthy mix of SMGs on their side as well. Flusher going for that MP7, which he has been favoring in recent matches, and Olafmeister with the Pro 90. So they know Kevlar on NiP means these weapons can shred them instantly. So we have to see if Fnatic can actually line up the shots. Olafmeister goes running in and takes Freiburg out instantly, and now it's going to be the man falling back onto this side for Florin. Has to hold the angle, and he gets the drop on Olafmeister, manages to pick up the gun.
Nicely done from Viflaren, and steals the P90 as well, which is kind of cool, but it would be even better if they could somehow get this P90 over to exist, because he's actually the only one who has body and head armor here, but he's all the way on the other side of the map. It's a really good shot from JW. Geralt goes down, and even with the P90, Viflaren can't hold this bomb site. 50 bullets is a lot, but not enough to deal with every single member of Fnatic coming in, so he's going to go down. It's the MP7 from Flusher seals it.
Yeah, 600 bucks in Flusher's pocket. He's going to be pleased with that. That's the whole purpose of that gun. Forrest calmly clicks Crims away though at long range, and now it's exist and Forrest alive. Scratch that, make it exist in a 1v3, just looking to do damage. He needs to find another frag, and that would be terrific here for NiP. They've already got two in this eco round. If he can get three, that's so much money that Fnatic have to spend. And exist goes for the fight, but Flusha and Pronax team up on him, and Fnatic managed to stay alive. 12 rounds, three members surviving, and that's kind of a mixed way. NiP, they can consider that a win.
It was all right. There's actually something I hadn't noticed in that last round, which was that by the time they kill Viflaren, there's about 9 seconds left. So a moment of terror, if the bomb planter dies or the bomb carrier dies to Viflaren there, that's actually a little bit scary. Fnatic cutting it close that round, but it turned out fine for them. And now they're only three rounds away from making this a 1-1 scoreline and moving on to Inferno as the third and deciding map of the Grand Finals.
Wow, this is all on NiP at this point. And once again, they go full CZs. They really are going to have to go for that 14th line, building the wall now and hoping that Fnatic won't be able to pound their way through. 13 rounds for Fnatic means once they take this round, they only need two to secure the win and move on to map three. But once again, Fnatic, I really do actually like the setup here from Fnatic. Three guys in mid, one, you know, towards A, one towards B, making sure that Nip can't get cheeky and peek out anywhere, start pressing for information. Nip will hear those nades go off mid, and we do have a bit of a rotation coming through, but again, it's just holding on the sights right now, Nip. They want the bleed time off the clock. They're playing Fnatic's game, really. They're not giving Fnatic any opportunity to get any free frags.
Yeah, but Fnatic have decided JW, since he only has a pistol, why not just use him as a scout and see if he can figure out something in the middle? And he doesn't actually spot anyone in that bomb site, so he's just going to be falling back to middle, where he's definitely going to run into a couple of people here. Freiburg up on the high ground towards the B bomb site, seeing if he can pick up anybody running in. And again, Fnatic going for B here. Garroy doing a lot of damage in the middle, though, and that could lead to something, but there's nobody covering him.
Yeah, and Fnatic just very thorough here, making sure that they smoke up everything, use the nades, stay alive. Olafmeister just mowing them down as they come rushing through. Nip plummeting out of the heavens, and the last man alive, Get Right, cannot get a frag. So a perfect anti-eco executed by Fnatic, and that was very clean work from them, keeping their cool and never really giving Nip the opportunity to drop them. Now we go to the crucial round. Nip, with four rounds on the board in the 19th round, go for their first buy. And it's rifles, nades, no AWP. They're just going to be planning on landing all the shots with the machine guns here.
Now, I said I don't think NIP is going to be able to make a comeback at 14-4. I think that's too much to ask. Of course it's possible, but they're going to have to convince me at least. I'm remaining skeptical at this point here. Yeah, JW with that AWP, NIP invested everything into this round. Probably be the most impressive comeback we've seen so far, because it's in a grand finals as well. If NIP somehow could win 12 rounds in a row on this map, that'd be insane.
Well, NIP, I don't think even know what the score is right now. They're just thinking one round at a time, one round at a time. We play our game, we focus, we do exactly what we did in practice, and we can make it work. But it would certainly be one of the biggest comebacks in history. Fnatic now, looking to see if they can't get over into a position to take on A. The rotation, however, coming in from Nip already, because they do have a man holding very close on short, and one who can apply the pressure from mid as well. So we have to see exactly how Nip managed to hold this, but the clock is ticking. There's only 45 seconds left now for Fnatic to make their decision, and it will be the A play. Pronax going for the molly at quad box. Exist is going to be rendered useless. He's caught in a corner.
Nice opening kill from Olafmeister. Flusher is going to follow up on that trend, and Get Right goes down. Forrest in the back. He's trying to stay alive, trying to see if he can get some more kills in, but he's going to get dropped by Pronax. It's a team effort. Pronax picks up a quick double kill, and Freiburg in the middle is going to fall to Flusher's headshot. An effortless round from Fnatic. Great grenades, flashbang, smokes, and everything, and they really do have this on lockdown. So far, it feels like that NIP had better strats and better idea of how to play Cobblestone. And on this map, which NIP picked, it seems like Fnatic are just in the driver's seat. It's going to come down to this round. It's 15-4 map point here for Fnatic.
Now, Fnatic have been the driving force of this map the entire way through. They knew exactly how to counter Nip right from the start, play super passive, and never give Nip the entry. And going into the second half here, what are they doing? No rushes willy-nilly, etc. apart from the start. They actually just slow everything down and then go for a very clean execute, something that Nip have sometimes a lot of trouble to deal with if they can't actually shut it down immediately. So Fnatic now one round away from taking it all.
Look at Forrest just sneaking up in here. This is really cool. Flusher has no idea. He's going to be walking back, but he has no reason to check it. He realized his teammate was just in the middle, so that's almost an execution coming out from Forrest there. Steals the AK and runs away. It's a pretty good round.
That's the weakness of having two guys boosted up like this. Then we have to see exactly where Fnatic, if they're going to manage to make it out mid in one piece, and they do actually manage to overwhelm, well, nobody, because nobody is here from Nip. They collapse back to the sites, and they want to maintain the man advantage, Nip. They want to make Fnatic work for this, and Fnatic with the firepower looking for the frags, but they can't find anything quite yet.
JW hoping someone's going to be forced back. I mean, if they just go peeking, he's going to take one down. So Forrest, for all that he did, is still going to be dropped. Freiburg has the bomb dome over by the playground. He's still going to go down. Olafmeister coming in from the vent room and taking him down. Fiflaren, flash goes in. JW point blank range with the AWP doesn't work out. And Fiflaren is going to go for a quick double. Very nicely done. And Crims is going to get the bomb down. And if he can clutch it here, no, he's actually going to wait. Again, he wants to go for a one-on-one instead of a one-on-two.
Absolutely. It's a dangerous game he plays, though. And with 10 seconds left, he will get that plant. Now he has to find the man peeking. The man working his way out on Sky. That sets it up, and he reads it! Crims gets Get Right, but can't get the final frag. Exist will find him from the heavens, and now there is plenty of time for the defuse. He has a kit. It only takes 5 seconds, but that's more than enough. And Nip hold it off one more round. Fnatic sitting on 15, but Nip with 5.
That bomb plant for Fnatic means, I mean, even without it, they still have plenty of money. I think it was 11,000 on Pronex at the beginning of this round. So NIP have to win a number of consecutive rounds here before they can start to force ecos. 10 in a row could be done, but you have to imagine, you have to calculate for the amount of pressure that's on NIP right now. Everybody realizes one single entry frag for Fnatic that could seal the deal.
That's exactly what they're going to be looking for here. Nip changing up a little bit how they're holding, but Fnatic not really giving them the opportunity. Once again, we could not have any aggression on the other side either. It's really just Nip spreading out.
I think Flusher just saved himself. He threw a flashbang that's actually meant to counter Get Right if he's in a slightly different position in that bomb site. Mm-hmm. And Flusher flashed himself and then backed up. I think if he had kept pushing, he would have been picked off on Get Right, I think. I mean, that was accidental, but it was kind of funny.
Opportunity here for JW to strike. He's trying to click away the headshot on Forrest, but he's not going to manage it. Drops down to 32 HP, decides to try again, Crims. And Crims is going to take the fight. Forrest not finding the frag there either. Drops him down to 28. The door is politely closed, but it's going to be Flusher finding Get Right in the end on the other side of the map.
Nice kill on the one guy who has an AWP, so Flusher coming right back into it here. They are low on healthy. Flaren is not going to realize, and actually that may be maybe a bit of a mistake here. They should have probably realized there was going to be someone pushing up here. Now it's a 3-on-5, so Fnatic, they're inches away from doing this. Third map might be coming up. Forrest is snuck in. He's going to get the one kill. He didn't spot anyone, but there was someone there, so now Forrest is going to be trapped in here. Can he stay alive? AWP and all of Meister says no, sir. JW charges in. Freiburg trying to hold it. A really cool flashbang. Picks up the one kill. He needs a lot more, and he's not going to get it. It's all of Meister. Again, double kill, Exist, 1-on-2, 15 seconds as the bomb goes down. Oliver's gonna be dropped here, Exist trying to clutch it. And JW's on 12 HP, switches sides, trying to see if he can bait out Exist here. And the Swedish captain waiting on the other side, seeing if he can get it done. Ticking away, he has got the kit, he's creeping up slowly, and JW's walking around the other side, firing a shot, he reveals his position instantly. That bomb is far tick, but Exist has the perfect angle for it. Very smart play, cold as ice, and it's gonna be another round for NIP.
The perfect haunting down there, but Fnatic, they have so much cushion right now going into this. The damage that they have just inflicted to Nip's economy by killing off 4 members, we can see the effect that that has here. Nip still no bank on their side. They have to spend everything to re-equip once again. So Fnatic are going to be very pleased with the outcome of that last round. They just want to find themselves in these positions where they're going to be able to apply maximum pressure to Nip and make sure that Nip have so little room to work with here. Excuse me. It really does come down to Nip not really caring. Just managing to find the frags, really.
And it's so close all the time. This time was actually a double entry from Fnatic. They had a 5-1-3 and they ended up still not quite winning the round. So it was really close. And NIP has to be worried. If every round is down to a one-on-one clutch, that means probably before the comeback happens, it's going to go the other way. Forrest almost gets the opening shot there. That's dangerous, leaving that door open like this.
It's risky business, and Forrest crouches, puts his shot through the barrel. You can't shoot through those, unfortunately for him. But he will try and put one through the door. I love how Crims is playing a bit of a swag yet again. The smoke is going to go down to block off Forrest. Forrest quickly changing his position. This could be a highly likely spot for him to get picked off. However, Olafmeister already trying to pre-fire around that angle. But there's yet to be a frag here. Nip already rotating in to shut this down. Exist strikes first at Fifloren. Exist lighting them up as they get onto this site. Olafmeister flanked by Fifloren. It's finally going to get one for Flusher, but not for long. Forrest finds him in the end, and Nip will collect their 7th round.
Holy hell, Exist has been playing well in the last 3 or 4 rounds, just picking up so many kills. He's up to 16, which is still some distance away from the scores that Olafmeister, Flusher, and JW are dropping here, which are 22 and 21 kills each. Definitely very impressive, but he's trying to catch up right now. And Fiflaren also at 12, Forrest on 14. So NIP are slowly inching their way back. They need to win another 8 rounds in a row. But at the very least, they have forced an eco on Fnatic, and they're actually going to be charging in. Forrest gets the one kill here. Some backup needs to come in quick. He's actually going to get it as well. Freiburg, the buddy system, it works out once again.
Tower, very well played, and that is going to be a perfect hold. Nearly, Fifflaren getting dropped, but still keeping the important rifles alive here on Nip. They can afford to re-up, re-buy, as long as only one or two members gets caught.
Now, what I would love is actually for a bit of wisdom and advice that Sean Gares gave us during the analysis, and that was an auto sniper. Sean said, all right, if they get a rotating auto sniper, one that's really mobile, that can walk around everywhere, it could be devastating on a map like Cash. And NIP have the money for it. They don't need to save up money any longer. If they lose around, they lose the gate of the map here. Forest in the middle, like Crim's actually trying to see if he can pick up any more. Is he going to find the kill? They should be able to pick this up. If Laren's really low on health fighting in the corner, he's going to get taken down by JW. A lot of confusion there.
Yeah, perpetually flash, but that was great play. Forest, however, peeks forward and manages to pick off Olafmeister, brings it back to a 4-on-4 situation, and Nip managed to hold for now. With Fnatic, they've got control of mid. This opens up the avenues towards that A site, through the vents towards the B site. And so now they have decisions to be made. Where exactly are they going to take this in the end? If they're really going to be trying to sell the fake to Nip, try and make noise, go one way, and then juke left and go the other.
It's an equal situation at the moment. Forrest creeping down. He actually made some noise jumping down, but he picks up that angle on Flusher. That's an unlikely shot to find. I actually think he was walking in there to try and pick up somebody in the vent. And then Crims is going to see Get Right coming miles away. Very nicely done. So now we're straight back into a 3-on-3, and we're at about 35 seconds. I think this is going to be a push to the A bomb side. The bomb's all the way over here. And Forrest, he can hear that door opening if it comes, but Crims is coming in from the other side. Can they stay focused here in IP? One mistake, and it's going to be all over. And that might be it. Forrest goes down. Freiburg and Exist are left, and Exist will pick up the kill. Can he do it again? Can he save in IP for another round? He's going to go down, leaving Freiburg to clutch it, and that's not a bad man to have left in this position.
Exactly. They haven't quite spotted him out yet, but they are going to be able to get into afterplan positions here, Fnatic, and this is going to make life very difficult here for Freiburg. He has two angles to check. As soon as he shows himself to one member of Fnatic, the other one is going to peek out and catch him in the back. But Freiburg looks, and as he turns away, Crims, with the perfect timing, collects the headshot. 16-8, the final score on Cash for Fnatic, and this will go to map 3-handers. This will be settled on Inferno.
Absolutely fantastic. Well played, Fnatic, bringing back here. That was definitely something else. And I think NIP at the very least managed to prove that they could get some rounds at the end. So they might have, you know, just saved their own sort of mental state just a tiny bit here, but it's still gonna sting quite a bit.
Yeah, this is what we saw from LDLC in the first match, in the semifinal match, right, with Nip. They never give up, they keep fighting, they keep getting rounds, and that just gives them confidence back going into that second map. It allows them, or into that third map, rather, but it's just basically them fighting their way back into the game, showing that they're capable of picking up frags and that Fnatic are not invulnerable.
Yeah, but before we go to the third map, let's throw it over to the analyst desk where Scoots is waiting. Take it away.
Thank you, gentlemen. Again, do or die, down to our third map. It's what you want in a grand final. You don't want either side to 2-0. You don't want them to be easy. Although, that was looking really, really easy for Fnatic in the beginning, right? They go up 11-4, but again, Nip, in typical Nip style, starts to make that slow comeback, but not quite, again, enough.
Well, I did highlight it. I hate to say I told you so. I did say before we went into that, like, I don't understand why Nip keep on picking Cash. I think they've got like about a 50% win rate on it overall. I've seen them lose, and when they lose, it's typically a blowout. You know, they don't take a lot of rounds. They've got this system where they have Get Right picking up an AWP, and it just doesn't seem to really work for them on the T side. So I really am confused why they stick into this idea that, you know, Cash is a strong map for them, and Fnatic have the players that can, you know, win that map.
Yeah, and I honestly think the map was decided probably in the first five rounds or so. You saw Nip win the pistol, they lost the eco. I think they may have won like a stress buy shortly after that.
Yeah, it went to 2-2.
And then Fnatic quickly won back to reset Nip, and Nip's economy was like in shambles at that point. And Fnatic took an early lead on them, maybe like 5-2 or so. And then you saw Get Right use the AWP, like you said. And I've never been a fan of Get Right using the AWP, especially on T-side Cash. I feel like he's more of the lurker role on Cash. He lurks that B area. So when he's AWPing, it really puts a whole twist in the dynamic of Nip's terrorist side on D-Cash. Yeah. So I hope they don't do anything like that going forward on Inferno. And I can't see them because, I mean, they've never done that before, but
Obviously, we're talking about, you know, what Nip have done wrong. I think it's fair we talk about what Fnatic did right. So much that Crims might be having some nerves played out of his skin again. So talk a little bit about him, what you noticed.
I think JW had a fantastic match. There was a couple rounds where he was up in quad where he got like four kills or so, and Nip really had no answer for his AWP. It was just rotating around the map, BA, like they just had no answer. He was playing so aggressive, and NIP had no solutions throughout the whole half after their early failures. And I mean, it was just utter domination that first.
Yeah, it was a really solid performance all around from Fnatic. Now it's anyone's game when we move into this third map. I don't know psychologically how that affects them, because when you lose a map that you pick, and you know, we know that Pronax is probably hurting from Cobble, well now Nip have got to be hurting going into the decider, that a map that they're absolutely adamant they can win, and they lose like that.
Yeah, especially when they just lost on Inferno against LDLC. I mean, that was a very weird Nip against LDLC on Inferno, though. I had never seen him miss that many shots before. So, yeah.
Let's hope it's a different story this time around, so it's a bit more competitive.
I think their strategy in that match was sound. It was perfectly fine. They just weren't hitting shots early in that LDLC match. I think this match right here is going to be a totally different story. They're going to start T-side too, which is a little bit different. They have time to sink in.
Oh yeah, we've got the stats up now, which is great news. So you can see straight away, I think Crims has been kind of, he's changed teams. Maybe that's the sign of things to come, a late transfer. Oh, it's happened. They're going to give Nip six guys.
How do they and they lose. It's 6-on-4 and they still lose. Wow. Deranked.
But you're absolutely right to point out JW. His AWPing was absolutely key. I thought Crims was solid. You see Olaf was solid. It was just a great consistent performance across the board from Fnatic. Forest and Exist were really the two that kind of stood out. Exist especially, he made a couple of 1v1 clutches. But ultimately, they didn't really get going on Cash at all.
Yeah, I think looking at this scoreboard, the one difference you know from Cobble to Cash, look at Get Right. Goes from 32 frags to 11.
Yeah.
NIP is really going to need Get Right to be at very least second on the scoreboard if they're looking to bring home this championship.
Yeah, absolutely. So we start looking at Inferno. I've got no idea how this is going to go. I mean, I didn't want to call it. You said 2-1. Yeah. We're lined up for that. Yeah. It could still happen, but I mean, Fnatic are going to be feeling good going into this. As far as they were probably concerned going into Cash, they were done and dusted. Yeah. And you know, this is like the last chance saloon for them. Yeah.
I feel like NIP has notoriously had some troubles with Fnatic, particularly JW on Inferno. Yeah. He likes to play up in the halls with ops and stuff like that. And just it really throws Nip off their tempo. And I hope they have a solution for it, so that way it doesn't get out of hand. I definitely see this coming down to the wire.
Are you sticking with your prediction?
Yeah, I'm going to stick with my prediction. I'm going to go with NIP winning this map.
Oh, dude.
Don't back out.
I don't know what to do. I'm so glad I haven't got skins riding on this, man. That would suck. But no, I think Nip is still just going to do it, but man, this is just—it's just been a crazy final and a crazy tournament throughout, really.
Yeah, and again, this is what you want to write. You want to write all the way to the final. And again, we've discussed the new maps, and you know we had one in this series, but you know we are ending on a tried and true Counter-Strike map in general, but certainly the most popular map in pro tournament play. You know, not Dust 2 matchmaking here on Inferno. So again, there will be no random bickering about they won on a newer map.
It's a really balanced map as well. I mean, it's ideal to showcase the talents of both of these.
We can't end on a better map. I mean, this is what everyone wants. They want to see one of the main maps. They want to see both teams at their top, and I think that's what we're going to get in this final map.
It's like we planned it.
Yeah. Just so everyone knows, you know, this is our last little segment. You know, when there is the big fanfare and we do have a winner, they're not going to come back to us and analyze and everything. That's kind of that Debbie Downer thing, right? So Red Eye and the gang at the stage will take care of it. So I wanted to give all of us an opportunity to kind of give our final thoughts and wrap up our desk. And starting with you, Sean, your final thoughts on the tournament and a little bit about, you know, what's up for Cloud9 next.
I mean, a lot of people are giving Valve heat for the veto processes, the map pools and things like that. But what they need to realize is what Valve has done over the last year and a half. When we were playing CSGO, the players on this team right now in Cloud9, we were playing CSGO with 10,000 players a day. Right now we're at 200-something thousand, I believe, was the update today. It's insane the progress that 5 devs for CSGO have made over the last year and a half. And I am truly grateful for what they've done for the game. It's really like a huge part in all of our lives as pro gamers. So props to Valve. thank you for Cloud9 for sending us here. Thank you for Logitech for all of their support. And it's really been probably my favorite major so far.
Just for me, I got to say, you know, back in 2005, I shoutcasted my first ever game of Counter-Strike. It was on TeamSpeak. I had 80 people listening in the channel. It was for a reloaded community cup for my pub server. And I always knew Counter-Strike could grow. It would be something like really special. I always believed it, but I never thought that by the time it did, I'd still be part of it. So to be part of this major, even in a small thing, and everything that's been achieved, I'm really humbled and honored. You know, I think the community's done a sterling effort. I think all the players have really raised their game as professionals. I think ESL have put on an absolutely fantastic major, and just this tournament for me has been the pinnacle of Counter-Strike. We've seen incredible series, and like I say, just honored to have been a part of it. Lasting memory, these guys, no doubt, man. NA's back, baby.
Yeah.
Great game, great series.
You know, and for me, I echo a lot of the stuff. You know, again, not too much story time with Scoots, but it is just absolutely amazing to see our favorite game, certainly the one that got us into the world of esports for me, to have ascended to what it even was back in its first heyday. You know, we're setting record in-game, we're setting records in GoTV, we're setting spectator numbers on Twitch. It's blowing up. And every major, it's had a huge bump. And again, we're going to have more majors. This is not something that Valve's going to stop doing. Right. Obviously, the eSport cases are still dropping, so keep buying those keys. They keep adding. First, they did capsules. Then they did the capsule stickers with the Pick'em system. So again, they're going to keep adding all this fun stuff, which is great. And again, as an old guy, it's just I'm honored, you know, that I get asked to do this kind of stuff. A lot of people could sit in this chair. You know, I'm certainly not the best host. I'm not the best at all this stuff. But it just warms my heart that I can sit and kind of be part of this history, you know, and that's really it. So, you know, big shout out to ESL. This is a different environment. Gamescom is not like being in a stadium, and there's lots of different challenges with that. Yeah. Sometimes people at home don't get that. They look at what's happened before and go, this is nothing like that. And it's the nature of this particular venue. Gamescom is the largest gaming event on the planet, and there's 9 halls around us. It's a little more confining in what ESL wants to do, right? Yeah. So obviously we want our own stadium, we want big stuff, and I think as this keeps growing, you're gonna see that it's not just Dota and League of Legends and StarCraft that are in their own stadiums, but we hopefully you folks will travel and will start filling stadiums so that we have that badge of honor, not just these big numbers.
I just hope you're young enough to appreciate it.
Yeah, I just gotta stay alive, you know? So thank you guys. Obviously, Sean, thank you to all the pro players that helped us all weekend long. It's been amazing to hear these guys as the true analysts at this desk, because that's insight that nobody else can give us. Yep. Thank you for joining me. Great as always.
Always a pleasure, brother.
You know, and again, on behalf of me, thank you everyone for tuning in. And again, now it's time. We're going to see the winning moment from Fnatic on that one, and then the last map of the grand final with Anders and Semler.
As soon as he shows himself to one member of Fnatic, the other one is going to peek out and catch him in the back. But Freiberg looks, and as he turns away, Crims, with the perfect timing, collects the headshot. 16-8, the final score on cash for Fnatic. And this will go to map 3, Anders. This will be settled on Inferno.
Oh, here it comes. Ladies and gentlemen of the audience, it's a third map for the grand final. Can we make some noise? What a great game it's been already. Now we are ready to see how this is going to turn out on Inferno.
Look at this. The major title championship is about to be settled on map 3. It could not be better. It's a winter rematch, and Fnatic and NiP will clash in a moment's time. But we have to get hype. We have to make noise. We have to let the whole venue know that this is happening. It's going down here.
Make some noise. Third map hype here. We have Counter-Strike. We've opened up a whole new scene now to fit everyone in. So now we have double the audience here at Cologne. It's absolutely fantastic. I can't believe it.
Nah, neither can I, man. This is absolutely amazing how many people have been tuning in, how the community has grown. But it's a thing of beauty that we have before us here, Anders. Fnatic clashing against NiP to settle everything here. Fnatic on the brink of picking up their second major title. This is the first time in history that a team would collect 2 major titles. Fnatic, with Pronex at the helm, could be the team to do it.
They very well could. They were looking on point and ready for a map that wasn't one of the new maps with cash. And that is definitely scary for NIP, because the next map is one of the best well-known maps in the whole pool. Inferno, probably one of the maps that teams end up playing the most at almost any tournament, especially before this major tournament. It was very popular in best of ones. So we'll have to see. If NIP can't figure out a way to change things up, there's probably a good chance that Pronex is going to know not everything, but maybe a large enough part about what NIP are doing to take the victory.
Well, they've done it once. That's the thing. Fnatic, they've taken NIP out once to claim their first title. And if anybody knows NIP, it is Pronax. And we saw that clearly demonstrated on Cash. Pronax has got NIP dialed in right now. Every decision made was one to cancel out whatever NIP were throwing at them. And it was very well done by Fnatic. So going into Inferno, it really is going to be focused on B-side, I think. And this is something that I got from Semphis outside as well. We discussed it during the break, but he really thinks that B-side is going to be everything here for NIP and for Fnatic. And we know who plays on Fnatic or on B-side for Fnatic. It's Olaf Meister and Krims, the two heaviest hitters on this team right now. So it's going to be one hell of a mountain for NIP to climb, but we should be loading into the map in a second's time.
Yeah, well, actually, before we do that, we are just going to make sure we can get everything sorted out here on the stage. We'll go to a really quick commercial break, and then we'll be right back, guys. So don't go anywhere. It's going to be the third map. Stay tuned.